Oh boy, that was funny. Thank you so much. It's so great to see so many smiling, happy faces. And we're coming back to concert making. And my name is Daniel Rubinoff. I'm the new music director here at this wonderful church, Lawrence Park Community Church. I've been saying to Reverend Stephen Milton, this is my seventh week. So that's definitely a lucky number. The 7 days in creation, and we're all the eighth day or the eighth night, as it were. I know Shakespeare did 12. I was imagining this concert as a kind of a musical offering to the community. So you're not paying any money to come in here, although there's already been mountains of donations, and that's really, really great, because we want to build the music program on the tremendous legacy of my predecessor, Mark Toews, and he and many other people, these wonderful soloists that we have tonight. We've got three of our wonderful LPCC soloists, Kim and Michelle and Paul, and a wonderful guest from up the road, John Holland, helping to sing. So this is a part of my musical career as a concert saxophonist and as a composer. And when I went to music school, one of my composition professors said, you know, Daniel, always write what you know, always write what you do and where you are and what you're playing with. So I love playing with voices and saxophone. And it's a special and a great honor to introduce my longtime musical collaborator, Christopher Dawes, who for years was at the helm of St. James Cathedral downtown. And we've had a long and illustrious musical partnership. We've played all over Canada. We've recorded CDs. And I just love working with Chris, because not only is he a great musician, he's a great friend, and he's a great thinker on music. And we're always engaged in wonderful musical dialogue. And speaking of dialogue, we're going to start this evening's program with some music by Georg Philipp Telemann, this heroic music as we enter the season of remembrance and All Souls and All Saints. We remember the heroes of our lives, and I have many in my musical journey. And these are wonderful pieces, originally written for trumpet, but because the saxophone was invented late in the musical narrative, sometimes I shouldn't say this in church, but sometimes I like to steal music and adapt it for the saxophone. So I hope you enjoy three movements from the Heroic Suite by Georg Philipp Telemann. the saxophone trying to sound like a Baroque trumpet. I mean, what gives? But one of the great joys of being a church music director, especially here, but really in all the positions I've had, this idea that you can sort of, with the right team, and we've got a wonderful team here, so many people have supported me already in my short little tenure. And, you know, just in terms of putting this concert together, we've had some COVID illness, we've had other challenges, and yet here we are. So it's a testament. I kind of think we should all just give them a clap for all the wonderful team support here at the church. You know, when Chris and I started partnerizing years ago, as I said, because the saxophone was invented in 1840, so it was a rather late invention. Adolf Sax, the inventor, his vision was to create an instrument that would bridge the woodwind and the brass section of the symphony orchestra. Little did he know that it was going to really flower in the United States as a jazz instrument. So it's kind of an interesting story. We like to weave a narrative through that. So when Chris and I, years ago, were trying to find music, we came across a lot of French music, a lot of music written in France, because saxophonists were really learning to be persuasive and learning to ask composers to write for their new instruments. So the next two pieces by the French composer Eugène Botza really highlight the singing qualities of the saxophone and also the propensity for brilliance. And again, hats off to Chris for his wonderful arrangements and accompaniments of this music. Do you want to say something while I put my reed on?
Okay.
You're never short.
Hello, yes. So the organ was invented considerably earlier than the saxophone. It's an instrument with tremendous street cred. However, it hasn't been paired a great deal with this particular instrument. And sometime over 20 years ago, this fellow named Daniel Rubinoff, called me up at St. James Cathedral with the idea of doing a CD. And after I sort of answered why, I actually discovered it is a really remarkable musical combination, and we have had a tremendous amount of fun over the years finding music, adapting music for it, and sharing it with audiences like this one. The fact is that the sound production of the saxophone is a great match for the organ. The wind instruments kind of are in kindred spirit, if you like, with the organ, which is a wind instrument of sorts. And in addition, just the simple, beautiful, quiet singing tone, contrasted with its incredible power, makes this a remarkable partner for the organ. So it has been a wonderful journey, and we're delighted, actually, for the first time in several years, to be sharing this music with you tonight.
Well, it occurred to me in my musical journey that I was sort of specializing in an instrument that didn't have a lot of original music written for it. And so I started writing music. I think it was my father who was went to school with Mo Kaufman and frequented the House of Hamburg. My father's claim to fame is that he played with Paul Desmond, the great saxophonist for the Dave Brubeck group. My father is a drummer and a pianist. I think as a little boy, I listened to the music at home, and my mother tells me that I would not stop dancing in my crib. So I think these rhythms sort of penetrated my soul, and I started writing music, and I got influenced during a master's degree with some composers who took us through the whole journey of music, really from the single voice all the way up, and a lot of liturgical music. Of course, I was already a church musician and working with these voices and these sounds. So it's a great pleasure for me to welcome up our wonderful LPCC soloist, Kim Briggs, Michelle Bogdanovitz, and Paul Winkelmans, and John Holland, our guest baritone, to the stage as we get set to do some music here. Come on up, guys. I'll get my music out of the way. Maybe we'll just move this back. If you want to just move those stands back, that's probably the easiest thing. Yeah, just throw them back. Thank you. I have to pay them extra now because they're doing some of the grunt work for me, which is wonderful. And so, well, thank you. This is this first piece, Kyrie, is really very, you know, most composers have to come to terms with the Catholic Mass, and it's sort of a rite of passage. So this is one movement from that. And I'm really interested in a very early music sound with some surprises that make it sort of a contemporary piece. And thank you, soloists, for working so hard on this music. Da Pacem Domine is sort of related to the Telemann heroic music, in that the translation in Latin is Lord, give us thanks, give us peace. And so it is, in my version, a cry for peace, a cry for peace. And I don't need to tell you how important that is today. And when we yearn for peace, of course, many different emotions come to the fore. So we'd like to perform for you. We've never done this before. These were especially composed for this evening's performances with singers and organ and saxophone, the Kyrie and Da Pacem Domine.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. I have just realized I've left the next piece of music over in my bag here. So while I go and retrieve it, I'm going to tell you a bit about it. Paul Halley is an English-born but Canadian-raised musician, fine musician with a great pedigree. And he, as a young fellow in his early 20s, was incredibly honored to become the organist of the Cathedral of St. John the Divine in New York City. Magnificent edifice, one of the largest cathedrals in the world. And this particular musician has always had a number of influences which show through in his music. One of them is an interest in jazz, which you won't particularly hear in this piece. But he also is a great fan of the soulfulness of Celtic melodies. So the piece I'm going to share with you tonight is called Outer Hebrides. It is basically a fantasia on three Celtic tunes, which are not named, but which are not original either. Some of them certainly sound like original Celtic tunes, and they're not identified in the copy. But Paul sent me this piece after we had an opportunity to work together some years ago, and I've just fell in love with it. I think it's a very, very fine piece of writing, and audiences tend to agree. So I hope you will enjoy it too. Outer Hebrides by Paul Halley.
Thank you.
Well, as the Canadian philosopher Marshall McLuhan would say, the medium is the message. That was really quite a medium and quite a message. And I don't know how to follow that, except that, Eric Schumacher also said that small is beautiful. So I'm just going to reach into the organ case and take out a pipe here, a saxophone, which is a symbol. Many writers have written about the saxophone as a kind of a profane instrument, right? Because it found itself into speakeasies and bordellos and other places of questionable repute throughout its storied history. I've been someone who's very interested in mysticism from Teilhard de Chardin in New York, France, by way of New York City, to Taoism. I practice Taoist meditation, the Christian medieval mystical tradition, and the whirling dervishes of Rumi that I had a chance to see at the Aga Khan Center in Toronto. And so this next piece is incantation, and I am trying to put a spell on you, in the words of Nina Simone, with a jazzy instrument that has a whole repertoire or vocabulary of 21st century sounds as the saxophone searches for its own unique voice so that it doesn't have to beg, borrow, and steal music from yesteryear. You'll hear, hopefully, the spirits being moved and the keys being clicked. Here's Incantation by Daniel Rubinoff.
Thank you.
Thank you, Daniel, for that bewitching music. And again, I think you can sense some of the soul of the saxophone, its profane soul, if you like, bubbling up through. Daniel and I are basically classical players, but we, like a lot of the composers for his instrument especially, have a tremendous interest in jazz. We'll share a little bit more along those lines with you in the second half of the program. But we're delighted now to close the first half with the first sonata for organ and saxophone, one of the first actually ever composed, in point of fact, and the first by Canadian composer Denis Bédard. Denis grew up in Quebec City and eventually relocated to become the organist of Holy Rosary Roman Catholic Cathedral in Vancouver, where he is to this day. His music, I'm just going to read this little quote from his write-up here because I think you'll appreciate it. His music, essentially tonal and melodic, is characterized by a concern for formal clarity and immediate communication with as vast a public as possible. His music is very tuneful. It's very elaborate in its way, but it also has a kind of simple honesty. And I think you'll see this coming through in all three of the movements of Sonata Number 1. There is, as Daniel mentioned, not very much music actually specifically composed for our combination, which is why we have to adapt several. So this is a particular treasure that we recorded right back in the early days, and that we've been playing together ever since. There will be a 10-minute intermission?
Yeah, 10 or 15 minutes intermission, so you can stretch your legs and talk to one another, and then we'll be back at it with lots more great music. second half of the show. Thank you for sticking around. Most people did stick around.
That was not a composition of Ruth Watson Henderson's, if you're curious.
I beg to differ.
If there is another currently living name that is more of a fixture of the choral scene in Toronto, I can't imagine what that name is. Ruth is still very active concert goer. She is, I run into her quite frequently at things that I do. She's a strong supporter, as probably some of you know, of the Toronto Children's Chorus, which she accompanied for many, many years. But if you don't know Ruth as a composer, she is actually fairly late to this game that we're trying to encourage of composers writing works for organ and saxophone. This work was brand new when we performed it at Timothy Eaton Memorial Church in
the 2006,
mid,
I think.
It would have been the teens somewhere, 2013, 2014, something like that. Yeah, but anyway, so this is a fine work, and there is a Lawrence Park connection with Ruth, isn't there, Dan?
Yeah, I mean, if you go by our kitchen, just around the corner, you'll see a lovely picture of Mark Toews and Ruth Watson Henderson. So she attended many, many Fridays at 8 concerts here, and of course, as Chris mentioned, she had a longstanding tradition as a very, very fine accompanist, and she's a wonderful composer. And someone who really supports performers and is always eternally someone who's open to new music and wants to move forward. And I think she's a wonderful inspiration to so many of us who are really following in her footsteps. So we'd love to perform this beautiful work. It's a bit of a stretch. I think it's a bit related to the mystical that I was talking about. And it also has some affinity with jazz and her beautiful sense of a fluid melody. I hope you enjoy it.
All right. The next number is actually an opportunity for you to become involved. Do we have projected words to this hymn? Excellent. Thank you, Judy. Okay. Great. So the story behind this hymn was written in 1901. It actually has 15 verses, most of them which you've never heard and are never sung or published. There are usually about three in this version that appears in Voices United is the inspiration for this arrangement. We attend, my family and I, the Christian Reformed Church in Georgetown, and for many years our pastor was a fellow named Tom Van Milligan. Tom was a musician, and he came up with the idea that this familiar children's hymn could kind of work as a jazz waltz. And so I helped him at one time to sort of work out just exactly how this would happen. And so the result is what we're going to sing. Now, you don't have anything to adapt. I think you'll get the hang of it very, very quickly because it moves pretty naturally into this unusual rhythm. This is the hymn, of course, you might also know as "This Is My Father's World." This is my father's world, which moves in very sort of straight quarter notes. So the jazz simply moves it into a wonderful whimsical three, and it makes it kind of have a completely different character. So I hope you'll enjoy maybe rehearing this hymn for a new time.
But that's okay. This is all. So you don't need to exercise. You just need to give concerts, right? It's great. Well, this is another mystical piece. This is the Holy Spirit coming down and occupying us in an existential, mystical, spiritual way, regardless of what your religious persuasion is. So this is a very famous text, redesigned and never performed in this agglomeration tonight. So I'm very, very excited to have all these wonderful singers who have worked so hard again, and Chris on the organ and myself on saxophone. This is the original composition. Come down, O love divine. Well, I think it's time for a nocturne because it's getting late. It's as they say in Cape Breton, it's getting dark again. That's an old drinking song. But anyway, André Joutre is a jazzer, Quebecois jazzer. Such a wonderful tradition of jazz. And I think back to my teens in Montreal. It lasted a year at McGill University. The so-called Harvard of the North, but I was probably more interested in Le Soleil Levant and all the wonderful jazz clubs in Montreal. I used to make late night rendezvous with my father a couple of times. I stood him up because I probably was having a little too much fun at a fraternity party up in near Molson Hall. But anyway, that's a whole other story. There is a jazz component to this nocturne. Andrei Jutras, most famous for his jazz band arrangements, and he's made a career actually out of writing wonderful big band charts, and our wonderful tech team behind you, two of those gentlemen, the two gentlemen there are wonderful jazz musicians. So we have a very musical church here, lots of great musicians around to spur us on. But Chris and I really, really love this piece. It's a beautiful piece by Andrei Jutras. Lots of jazz elements, so the saxophone is in a natural place here. So enjoy our arrangement of this great Canadian piece of music. Well, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to Lawrence Park Community Church. Thank you to these wonderful soloists. Thank you to this amazing team. Thank you to Chris Dawes on the organ. Boy, so many things to be grateful for. And there's nothing like the gift of music. I've thoroughly enjoyed myself. And it's been such a joy to bring this music to life again after so long and with the pandemic and everything. And a few weeks ago, we did a wonderful thing here. A very high-profile litigator in Toronto passed away. And the whole team here, I don't know how we did it. We put together a real celebration for this wonderful man. And we had a lot of sort of high-profile people here, and it was a very elaborate ceremony, and there were so many different things to do, but it was just a labor of love. And one of the pieces was Hymn to Freedom, and just this idea that we are free to be, and free to give joy, and free to serve. And I think this is so emblematic of what's going on here at Lawrence Park Community Church, and I feel very honored and privileged to be a part of it. And Chris and I love playing this piece. Of course, it's written by the wonderful Oscar Peterson, and we just love the harmony, we love the soul, we love the gospel tinge, we love a little bit of Montreal, so it sort of fits in with a lot of the things that Chris and I hold very dear to our hearts. So Chris, I'd like you to come on up here to the piano. And we'd both like to just thank everyone for coming out tonight. We have a reception. Stick around. And we've put together just a few little refreshments so you can say hi to one another. And we'd love to meet you. So thank you so much. And here's our gift to you, another gift to you, Hymn to Freedom by Canada's one and only Oscar Peterson. Thank you.